Next, in case 3, if atom with the least priority, that is on the left hand side, okay, in this case, without changing the position of the top groups, okay, we had to rotate the molecule in anti-clockwise direction, okay, without changing the position of top group, rotate the molecule in anti-clockwise direction. So by rotating the molecule in anti-clockwise direction, okay, so this is the anti-clockwise direction, we get this, okay. Now we have to give the priority to this compound. So first, second, third priority, okay, and rotation is in clockwise direction, okay, and the compound is 2-aminopropanoic acid, okay. So 2-aminopropanoic acid. So this is case 3. Next, in case 4, if atom or group with least priority is present on the right hand side, okay. So here hydrogen is the least priority atom, it is present at the right hand side. So, in this case, without changing the position of top group, okay, we have to rotate the molecule in clockwise direction, okay. So, clockwise direction rotation takes place here, clockwise direction, okay. So, in clockwise direction, we get this. Now, we have to assign the priority, okay. So, priority wise, 1, 2, 3, okay, rotation is in clockwise direction. So this is R notation, okay, notation is given as R. So 2-hydroxypropanoic acid, R 2-hydroxypropanoic acid, okay. So, while giving R and S notation in Fischer projection formula, we had to follow all this. Okay. So, four types of cases we had to follow. Okay. Next, some objective bits. Next, objective bit. IUPAC name of this compound. Okay. So, this is the chiral carbon surrounded by 4 different groups. So this entire group is this is considered as a single group. Okay. So that is CHOHCH3 group. So coming to order of priority, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is numbering. So this is the long chain. And this is the chiral carbon. Then we have to give the priority. So first priority should be given to bromine. Okay. First priority. Then this entire group is given second priority. Okay. And methyl group is given third priority. Okay. And rotation is in clockwise direction. 1, 2, 3. So 2R. Okay. So, second chiral carbon shows R mechanism, R notation, okay. Then, third one. So, this is the chiral carbon surrounded by OH, okay. Followed by CH, H hydrogen, methyl and this entire group, okay. Then, here, we're taking this first priority must be given to this. Okay. Next, second priority. Second priority is given to this. Okay. Entire group. And third priority to methyl carbon. Okay. So third priority is given to methyl carbon. So from third carbon, here notation is S notation. Rotation towards anti-clockwise direction. Taking this, rotation is towards anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So here 2R, 2R, and 3S, 3S, 3-bromo, 2-butanol, 3-bromo, 2-butanol. Okay. 2R, 3S, 3-bromo, 2-butanol. This is the correct configuration. Okay. So 2R, 3S, 3-bromo, 2-butanol. Next, IUPAC name of the given compound. Here also, we have to give the numbering starting from functional group. So here 1, next 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So according to this, taking second carbon linked with methyl group and aldehyde functional group chlorine. Okay. So if we given priority to all the groups surrounded to it, okay, first priority should be given to chlorine, followed by CH2 total entire group. So this is the second prior group. Okay. Then we can ignore the least priority group and we consider this one. Okay. So while giving the wedge dash formula. So rotation is towards the clockwise direction. So 2R. Okay. Second carbon shows R notation here, chiral carbon. Next, coming to this carbon, double bond is there. Okay. So here CH, double bond C, Br and entire group. Okay. So double bonded carbon. Okay. If a double bonded carbon is there, we can give EZ notation. EZ notation. So EZ notation, that is, this is also depends upon the atomic numbers. Priority is given according to the atomic numbers. Okay. So if we consider this, this is surrounded by, this carbon is surrounded by bromine at one side and entire group is at another side. And if we consider this, okay. So, this is methyl group and this is hydrogen. Okay. So, here least prior groups are present here. Okay. And higher prior groups are present at the opposite side. So, this is CH2 and here CH3 and H. Okay. So, if we take this as higher prior, okay. So, they are present at the opposite side, okay, to the double bonded carbon atom, okay. So, that's why we can give E notation to this, Z notation to this, okay. So, for fourth Z notation, okay. So, Z notation, so 2R and 4Z, 4 chloro, okay, and the second position also having methyl group, okay, and fourth carbon having unsaturation, so 4 hexenol, okay. Next, so here A is correct answer. Next, select R isomer from the following. So, four different compounds are there. If you see this one, hydrogen is, which having least priority is occupied in top position. That's why we have to rotate entire molecule through 180 degrees and this gives S notation. And here hydrogen is present at bottom position, already bottom position, just we had to give the priority to the compounds. So 1, 2, 3, so anti-clockwise, this is also yes. Okay, then coming to A and B. So here hydrogen is present at the left hand side. Okay, that's why we had to rotate the molecule in anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so if you rotate the molecule in anti-clockwise direction, we'll get this compound HCHO, OH CH3OH. Okay, then we have to give the priority 1, 2, 3. So R notation. And this one, hydrogen is present at the right hand side. Okay, by keeping the position of this top group at the constant, we have to rotate in clockwise direction. Okay, if you rotate clockwise direction, hydrogen, chlorine, C2H5, CH3. So 1, 2, 3. Again, rotation is in clockwise direction. So this is also R and this is also R. So both A and B.